This episode, we're going to show you how to find the Dumbbell Nebula. This is harder to find than the Ring Nebula we discussed in a previous episode, because it is further away from any bright stars it can be used to locate it. The Dumbbell Nebula is a great target for both telescopes and binoculars, but rather than rush to your equipment, take a chance to get your bearings in the night sky. This way, you should find the whole process much easier. We're going to be using two asterisms in this episode. These are groupings of stars that do not make up one of the 88 constellations recognised by the Astronomical Union. The first asterism we will use is the Summer Triangle asterism. Locate the three brightest stars of the summer night sky, Vega, Deneb and Altair. This asterism is a very useful tool for navigating the night sky, plus made popular by Patrick Moore. It also contains some excellent astronomical objects, which we will hopefully cover in future episodes. If you are having problems locating Vega or Deneb, the Ring Nebula episode discusses how to find Vega, while the North American Nebula episode can help you find Deneb. Links in the description below. Notice how one of the stars on the triangle's points has a bright star next to it. This is Altair, and indicates the section of the triangle we will be interested in. To further pinpoint our position, we need to locate the Northern Cross asterism. This is a group of stars within the Summer Triangle that make up the cross part of the Cygnus constellation. At the end of the cross, we need to find a beautiful double star, Alvaro. Now, looking between the stars Alvaro and Altair is the two dim stars of the Sagittarius constellation. Out of these two stars, locate the star that is closer to Deneb and head north slightly. You should now see the Dumbbell Nebula. I used an O3 filter and a series of 5-second stills to capture this image. I found that the O3 filter really increased the detail that could be observed on the nebula by increasing the contrast. This clip shows what should be visible to you through the eyepiece. Believe it or not, that clip took 30 minutes of recording to produce. To improve this image further, I have stacked it together to give this combined image, which shows the faint ring of gas around the white dwarf as well as two larger masses of gas. The final image has had drizzling applied and brings out even more detail. It's at this point it might be a good idea to discuss what exactly you're looking at, because a Dumbbell Nebula is a planetary nebula and as such not a true nebula. This is in fact formed by a red giant collapsing after it is burnt through its fuel and cast off its outer layers, which are illuminated by the small core of the star, the newly formed white dwarf. Such sights are only visible for a few tens of thousands of years before the gas spreads out too far away from the white dwarf to be still visible. Well, that's all folks for another episode. Please comment if you've got any questions, like if you enjoyed the video, and subscribe for more astronomy videos. Goodbye and clear skies.